Welcome to Aarhus, Denmark.
The 2018
Hempel Sailing
World Championships.
10 Olympic classes plus kiteboarding. 1,400
sailors. 1,100
boats.
85 nations.
It's gonna be a
great event. Every 4 years, the 10 Olympic sailing classes come together to hold their world championships in a combined event. It's the biggest regatta in dinghy sailing outside the Olympics. And this time, the festival atmosphere, the blazing sun and the warm welcome of Aarhus meant everyone was looking forward to a fantastic week of competition. Along with the chance to win personal glory with a world title, the sailors also had the chance to qualify their nations for the Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games. 40% of the available places were to be decided here on the Bay of Aarhus. This is where the dream of Olympic medals starts to become a reality for the greatest stars in dinghy sailing. A first for a combined sailing world championship also saw kiteboarding join the program to blast over Danish waters and impress the crowds. The 49er FX class is a high-performance skiff-style boat with the same hull design as the men's version, with a slightly smaller rig and sail plan. First seen at the Olympic Games in Rio, Brazilians Martin Grael and Kahina Kunze had their dream result, winning the gold in their home games. After a nine-month adventure sailing around the world in the Volvo Ocean Race, Martin was back with her 49er FX partner here in Aarhus, with the aim of once again being on the top spot of the podium.
The 49er FX uses the same hull and deck hardware as the 49er, but the mast is shorter and the sail plan smaller. Ironically, in strong winds, this smaller version is often quicker on some points of sail than its big brother.
Last year in Porto, the Danish pairing of Jane Mae Hansen and Katja Salskov-Iversen took their first world title, before Jana became another 49er FX sailor to sign up for a voyage around the world on Vestas 11th Hour Racing in the Volvo Ocean Race. An experience that was still fresh in her mind.
The last 9 months I've been a part of the Volvo Ocean Race and just got back here 3 weeks ago and started sailing with Katja again. Obviously, yeah, it's been a different journey for me, both mentally and physically, very different. But I feel still feel sharp and happy to go into this World Championships with Katja. I think it's more long term. I would be able to take something from the Volvo right now and here in the FX. It's so different. It have to be like we're tacking every 10 seconds nearly, and we have to go in and out and be very like agile and physically. Where sometimes you get told we tack in 5 days in Volvo Ocean Race. And so it's very different, but right now it's a very different focused little thing, the 49er.
I've been sailing with some of the guys from my home club, been coaching some of the Danish FX, and then I've been just doing a lot of physical training inside. I built a 49er simulator, walked across that boom so many times. So I've been doing a lot.
I'm very happy to be here in Aarhus and home waters, if you can say so. At least it's in Denmark, so we are familiar with the area, and hopefully there'll be lots of crowds here, so super happy to be here.
Knowing the area is everything, but the thing is right now the wind is from west and it can be very tricky, but it's a good morning, it's a good weather, I think we're ready to race.
The 49er FX class was drawing plenty of attention before the racing had even begun. From Olympic gold medalists to local celebrities, there was plenty to talk about in this fleet. Add to this the fact that sailors like Martina Grail, Jenna Hansen and Tamara Escher-Goyen had arrived hot foot from around the world Volvo Ocean Race, and it was easy to see why this fleet was pulling the crowds. When the racing began, Jenna Hansen and Katja Iversen got off to a dream start in front of the home crowd by taking the first win of the event in the blue fleet, a feat that they repeated in the final race of the first day. Yet it was difficult to draw any significant conclusions from the early score sheet, as race victories seemed to be spread around the fleet. Counting first places was no indication of ultimate success. Instead, it was a confident and consistent string of results that put Austrian sailors Tanja Frank and Lorena Abicht in the lead going into the medal race. Although their head start didn't guarantee success, their 11-point margin over second-place British sailors Sophie Weglin and Sophie Ainsworth was a handy buffer. For the rest, the medal race would be a scrap for the podium. We join our commentary team, Alec Wilkinson, Evie Van Acker, Jordan Spencer and Jelly Tulloch for the 49er FX.
This is how they go into the 49er FX medal race. The leaders have a big lead over second place. Tanja Frank and Lorena Abicht of Austria have 11 points over Weglin and Ainsworth of Great Britain. It's only 3 points further back to third place, Beckering and Duetsch of the Netherlands. So the top four could win gold, the top five can win silver, and the top six could win bronze.
As we know, in a medal race, everything is possible. So, and sometimes, like, even it's unpredictable. So it's kind of, we will just do whatever we can do and everything what is possible for us. And I think cannot do more than this.
We're pretty excited. We're really proud of what we've done this event. Didn't start out particularly well for us, and we've just done our thing and kept going and plugging away. And it's fantastic to be going into the medal race in silver position. And whatever happens, we can be really proud of what we've done.
The question, can anyone reel in the Austrian leaders? And the Danes getting away in the middle of the fleet there, at the centre of the line. And the wind's getting really light. And these World Championships, they're really the biggest test for all the sailors since the last Olympic Games. Let's get the latest from the course. Here's Jenny.
Well, earlier it was looking like beautiful conditions out here because the sun was out, but as you guys saw, the breeze is dying now, and I think it's because the very beginnings of this cold front are coming through. So while it might be sunny on the race course, just over the city of Aarhus, there are dark clouds. It looks like there's rain in front of us, and that's essentially killing the breeze that we have on the race course. So to me, it looks like possibly the darker part of this cloud line is on the right-hand side. So maybe that's what they're betting for, and they're hoping that with it comes breeze and a shift.
It's going to be difficult for the rest of the fleet to hunt these two down and take their gold medal from them in these conditions. But Dobson and Tidy, Maloney and Meech, the silver medalists in Rio from New Zealand, hot on their tail. As we reach the halfway stage of this medal race in the 49er FX.
At the moment, I think there's a little tiny pressure line on this right-hand side, and it looks like the two Netherland boats think that as well. So they've tacked off early, whether or not they had bad lanes on the far side or not, but they're continuing out to this right to then try to connect the dots further up towards the right-hand side.
That's how the fleet are laid out, but we're seeing all sorts of different colours and motion on the water.
Something is coming, is fresh breeze coming in. Quite a lot of wind, actually.
A lot.
Oh, and we've got a capsize, and those are our leaders. Our leaders have gone over. Jenny, you're right beside them.
That is exactly what just happened. This huge right shift came through, and with it, pressure. And the Austrians got auto-tacked, and instead of being able to pull off, the auto-tack is when the wind makes you tack instead of you deciding to. It just capsized the Austrian boat. This is essentially disaster for them. That's the one thing that could take them out of gold medal position.
This is what happened.
This is what we call a massive right shift. Yeah. And I wouldn't be surprised if we see the Dutch teams, both of them, flying in front. Like, they were in a really bad position and...
And that means the Dutch have come through. Van Alten and Jongens, Beckering and Duetsch are now in contention, not just to win this medal race, but the second Dutch boat here is also in contention for snatching the gold medal away from the Austrians as they head upwind round the mark and then head downwind for the very final time. So from here, they've got one leg, and then it's a short dog leg, a short reach to the finish line. So the Austrians now, Frank and Abbott, for them to hold on to gold, need to start making their way up the fleet, and they're running out of time. What we've seen as well, that wind shift has affected the other Danish pair of Hansen, Salskov, Iversen, who were challenging for the bronze medal. They're now down in eighth and out of contention for those medals. But anything could happen, even though there's so little time of the race to go. And there in the top left corner of the screen, you can see the projected rankings, i.e. who's winning which medals. And at the moment, it's the Dutch, followed by the Austrians and then the Brits in third as they come to that bottom mark. And for the Dutch pair, it's victory. There's no medals for them. Now, here, finishing in second place are the Dutch pair of Beckering and Duetsch. They wave as they cross the line ahead of Grail and Kunze, and that may well just be enough for Beckering and Duetsch to take the gold medal. Denmark's Bad Nielsen and Olsen cross in fourth. The Agerup sisters, who cross the line in eighth place. And by my calculations, that means Frank and Abbott will cross the line for silver, and gold has gone to the Dutch. They were ahead, and then suddenly, on that last leg, a huge puff dropped them into the water, a capsize that sent them to the back of the fleet. From first to last, Frank and Abbott have to make do with a silver medal. Let me just confirm the rankings. Beckering and Duetsch then, gold medalists. The Austrians have to settle for silver, and Wegelin and Ainsworth of Great Britain get the bronze medal. And just out of the running, Grail and Kunze making their comeback here in the FX after timeout, finish in fourth place.
It just changed in the last lap, and with the lightning, it just sums up the week, I think. It was an amazing week, but very intense.
We knew it's never over until it's actually over.
We're happy to have a silver medal at the World Championship, and yeah, that's all that counts now.
We'll be back in Aarhus shortly for more action at the 2018 Hempel World Sailing Championships, where next up, it's the turn of the men's 49er fleet. Denmark's second biggest city began life as a Viking settlement in the 8th century, and its location soon saw it become a hub of seaborne trade. Hundreds of years later, its close association with the water is obvious at the 2018 Hempel World Sailing Championships. The 49er class has, over recent times, been one of the best breeding grounds for sailors learning their trade and then getting opportunities in other fast boat sailing, like the America's Cup. Like the 49er FX, it's fast, exciting and super competitive, and the fleet of 86 boats here were all ready to take each other on in a week of high-performance racing.
The 49er is fully powered in just 8 knots of wind. Any stronger and crews are changing gear to keep the beast under control. The combined crew weight is typically 155 kilos and an average height of 1.8 meters.
Sailing Since forming a partnership around 18 months ago, the British 49er pairing of Dylan Fletcher and Stuart Bithell have become the team to beat and didn't take long to find their rhythm and start winning events. This culminated in taking the 2017 World Championships in Porto and the right to say that they were number one team in the world.
We had a great year last year, bow number one. Slightly different this year, we've got to try and retain that and we'll see how we get on this week.
Season started in Miami earlier in the year and we won that and that was great. Since then we've done a lot of training. We haven't done as much racing as a lot of the other guys, focusing on some speed work and looking forward to Japan. We also do other types of training. You know, Stu does some climbing, we both sail our Moss, and that's really just about, you know, yeah, taking our mind off the 49er. There's been a few boats who have been fairly consistent, you know, all year. For sure the standards, you know, going up and up and up, and it'll be interesting to see how Pete and Blair slot back in when they jump in next year.
You know, the World Championships, everyone's going to be bringing their A game. It's actually a really interesting venue where we have some really big shifts.
This week it's sort of the first real test, with it being the chance to qualify Team GB for in the 49er class.
The British squad's really strong at the minute. Obviously we've got James Peters and Finn Sterrett, who are second at the World Championships last year. But we've also got another couple of teams in our training group that are pushing us harder in training. So yeah, that kind of environment's really good for us.
The Nippers are amazing, they do push us hard, and you've seen that in their results. Their results, they're going up and up and up. So hopefully we can get four boats in Gold Fleet and have a very strong week.
Fletcher and Bithell's campaign to win back-to-back world titles didn't get off to the best start, posting a 15th and a 23rd in their two first races. They found better form later though, with three race wins, and start the medal race day in fifth. The 49er is an overpowered beast that takes years to master, let alone succeed in. At least that's the commonly held belief. But this year, one team proved that raw talent could be a match for inexperience. Croatian sailor Simi Fantella won gold at the 2016 Olympics in the 470 class. But a year ago, he switched to a 49er with his brother Mihov as his crew. Despite being short on hours in the twin trapeze high-performance skiff when compared to many in the rest of the fleet, they took the class by storm, rarely posting a result outside the top 10 to lead by 13 points going into the medal race. Two German teams were behind, Tim Fischer and Fabian Graf in second, and Eric Heil and Thomas Blosel in third. But the list of those capable of medalling went down even further to sixth position.
This is how they line up for the 49er medal race. The Croatian Fantella brothers have a large 13-point lead from second-place German pair of Tim Fischer and Fabian Graf. And their teammates Eric Heil and Thomas Plussel sit third. Now, mathematically, the top three could win gold, but the biggest battles will be for silver and bronze.
Really confident we go and try to enjoy the last race of this championship. It was a really good week for us, so we go and give our best and enjoy it.
We are still in a good position to gain one place in the overall results, so we are pretty keen for racing today.
And we are seeing the Croatians in the lead and the Germans. Germany 13, Fischer and Graf right next to each other. Is this developing into a match race, Jordan?
A little bit of a match race. It's going to be, if I was the Croatians, I'd just have a loose follow.
And they've released the beasts. They are off in the 49er medal race and they are all clear. So a clean start for the whole fleet. Kiwis getting ahead nicely there, but the Croatians and the Germans starting at the committee boat end. Eric Heil and Thomas Plussel in third place overall. We're looking at them now and they're currently sitting in fifth, defending that bronze medal position.
And there is a few spots available, that people that can attack that bronze medal position. There's quite a few, you know, you go back to six in the fleet, you can all actually move up onto the podium. Whilst these two are getting enamoured with each other, at some stage, you do have to start thinking about the overall big picture.
as the two French boats come in to the top mark. It's Ruel and Amoros in the lead. Fry and Delpech of France, the other 49er crew coming in second. And then it's Great Britain's James Peters and Flynn Sterrett, the best placed British boat. New Zealand 45 in next. Dunningbeck and Gunn, all names that we've seen do so well on the Olympic circuits in recent months. But there is the battle for gold between the Croatians and the Germans, and they're just mirroring each other as they go round the mark. I think those two are going to be inseparable for the rest of this race. Fry and Depeche of France are in a bronze medal position. So Heil and Plussel need to get their skates on and start moving up the fleet. They're currently sitting one from last. They rounded that mark in ninth place, the Germans. The French building up a lead now as they approach this bottom gate. Ruel and Amoros in command. Fry and Depeche, the French teammates, coming and choosing the other mark. No, they're not. They're coming in this way. And then, right behind them, in third place, are the New Zealanders, Dunningbeck and Gunn. Overnight leaders, and currently the men holding on to the gold medal round the mark. The Fantella brothers of Croatia, fifth at the bottom gate.
So the French team, their tactics is just to go as fast as possible and to sail minimal distance to the top mark and finish this race on top. And yeah, in their advantage, really hope that the German teams are not doing so well. And that's exactly what's happening at the moment. The French are in first and second, and the Germans are in ninth and tenth. And this really changes the leaderboard, putting the French in second position at the moment and Fischer and Graf in third.
And it's a France 1-2, New Zealand in three. The French racing almost a perfect race at the moment. They just went out with their own tactics, stayed out of trouble, and are out in front. Ruel and Amoros of France, Fry and Delpech, their teammates, in second. Dunningbeck and Gunn of New Zealand in third. And at the moment, that means that the French pair of Fry and Delpech are sitting in a silver medal position. But these are our overall leaders. And if they continue as they are doing on this penultimate leg, they will take gold back to Croatia. Fischer and Graf and Heil and Plussel, the two German boats that began the day second and third overall, they are way back in ninth and tenth place. And that means they are risking seeing their medal chances slip away. Although overall, Fischer and Graf still just holding on to silver.
Oh, but look at this. Fry and Delpech are now closing in on the race leaders, their teammates Ruel and Amoros of France. And that is significant because if they get ahead of their teammates, then Fry and Delpech move into a silver medal position. Here they are, side by side, coming into the bottom mark. And the French have dropped the spinnaker, and through go number 14, Fry and Delpech, into the lead to win this medal race as things stand and take the silver medal position. That was a terrific move from the French team.
And then it's a photo finish between Great Britain and New Zealand, between Dunningbeck and Gunn and Peters and Sterrett. Then come the next French team of Ruel and Amoros, and then the Fantella brothers. Job done. Gold medal to the Croatians. And the man who won gold in Rio in a completely different class comes to the World Championships in the 49er and claims the gold medal and the world title.
Last year sailing with my brother, it's a new challenge since changing from 470, and to win a world championship in a second year, it's something that I didn't even have in my dreams. So we enter in the week, we know we are good if conditions allow us to sail at our best, And the goal was to win qualifications, and we managed to come back home with the goal. It's a bit nuts.
Confirmation then of how they finished, with the Fantella brothers then taking gold. What a performance. A victory in the medal race saw Fry and Delbech of France take the silver. And then Fischer and Graf took bronze. The Aarhus 2018 Hempel World Sailing Championships conclude in the next show with the windsurfers of the men and women's RSX class and a debut at a combined world championship event for the high-flying foiling kiteboarders.